Morning, guys. A little rain here in Oklahoma. It's about 85, 86 degrees outside, something like that. So back on the Camaro today. Got this side as good as I think I got it as good as I'm gonna get it. So I started working on this side again, or for the first time actually. So what I did is went ahead and run a long block across it. And you can see the high spots come through. So I tapped those down just a little bit. And so now, then I went over it with 80 grit. And now I'm getting ready to lay my filler across it. Same on this side. A couple of little high spots here. Went ahead and tapped those down. Just use this little hammer here. Over this and hit just down on those spots there. A couple of spots through here I went ahead and just tapped on a little bit. And yeah, getting ready to get after this bad boy. I got one little, I don't know what that is, flaw, whatever, I don't know. It's kind of a little crater there. And so I'm just gonna put just a little bit of fiberglass in that. And then I'll go sand that down, and then I'll go ahead and go over this whole area all the way down with a little bit of filler just to get it nice and straight. It's actually looks pretty good. It most of that filler will probably sand off there because it shouldn't have too many highs and lows, I wouldn't think. But yeah, that's what I'm doing right now. Got this all scuffed up. I got one area here that's pretty high, but there's something behind it, like pushing out on it. And so I'm not going to be able to knock that down anymore. So I got it down as low as I can get it. I'm going to skim this whole thing with filler, except for around here where this, I'll try to keep that off that because that'll crack. So kind of feather the filler in around these areas here and keep that for the for your door striker, because you don't want that to crank down on your paint and have filler underneath it and then freaking crack the crap out of it. That'd suck. So anyway, I'm gonna leave that area pretty much free of filler. What else? That's it for now. I'll bring you back when I have something worth talking about. See ya. All right, you can see I got it pretty thinned out. I may go back over that some glazing putty, just to fill any 80 grit scratches that I may not have sanded out with the 180. You can see here, it's this. I probably need to tap down just a tad more, and I probably will. And then I'll just run another little tight coat of glaze over it. And that glazing putty and filler are direct to metal. And then I'll go over the whole thing with epoxy so it'll all be sealed. And to me, the only time you really got to worry about, I mean, you're not going to have, unless you've got something on the backside, like a weld or something there, that it's able to, that the moisture is able to creep into and then make its way out and start rusting out. I've coated the insides of these with that internal frame coating, so it should be good to go from the inside out. And as long as he doesn't drive this in the salt where it eats through that coating and starts the rust process, it should be fine. And I'm pretty sure he's not going to do that, so we shouldn't have too much to worry about. This should last for a long time. All right, that may be it for today. Like I said, I'm going to glaze this real quick and run over it with the 180 again, and then it'll be ready for high build. All right, see you guys.